Sheen, she remembers as first as Mr. Feistokofala in London.
A very good evening and welcome to a real rocking arena here in the Centennial Hall in Wrocław in Poland for the men's 77 kilo championship of the world, alongside myself, Debbie Goldstrom, as ever, Michaela Brees with her expert eye on 11 of the best to be striving for this prestigious title. We're just about 7 minutes away now from the first lift, and as you'll see in a moment here, this hall really is now with an atmosphere that we've been missing for the early days. But one of the reasons for that is that Poland have got a live medal chance in the shape and form of Krzysztof Sawaric. And this, of course, the early singing here with the lifters in this excellent warm-up facility. And there is the man of the moment as far as the Polish fans are concerned. But this is a field which is packed with talent. We've got world champions, Asian champions, Pan-American champions, European medalists, Olympic champions. And the body weights, which were finalized in the last hour, range from 76.23 to 76.98, and here are the contenders. And there you can see Dumitru Kaptari of Moldova. He is the heaviest at 76.98. And Erkan Çelimaj of Albania, the lightest man at 76.23. But now an opportunity to meet each of the contenders in person, beginning with this man representing Bulgaria, Demir Demirev, world bronze medalist back in 2007. This is the hope of Poland. This is Krzysztof Sawaric, seventh in the Olympic Games. Next, the Olympic champion and two-time world champion. And then 79. So just about 3 minutes to go, and before we get underway here, the B group, which contested the 77 competition earlier in the day, the best performances came in the snatch and also in the clean and jerk from this man, Alejandro González Baez, representing Spain. And this, after two successes, 142-146, this, Michaela, was his best snatch effort.
Yeah, really attacked right through the middle, didn't he? Working hard, up to 147, just 1 kilo ahead of his second attempt. Great lifting from
And then in the second half of the competition, 178, and then coming up with the second attempt here at 183. And this ultimately was his best clean and jerk.
Taking his time, really just rocking in the set position there, building himself up. Exploding into the clean, working hard to stand out.
Couple of steps forward, but he makes it. And putting the 183 clean and jerk together with the 147 snatch, giving himself a total of 330 kilos, and that is the leading score at the moment. So that is the score that tonight's finalists have to overcome to make sure that he doesn't climb up the table. 330 in comparison to the totals that have been put in is good, but it's modest by the A group standard, which is what we're going to see today. There's the man of the moment, the world record holder, the two times world champion, the Olympic champion. And just to whet your appetite, about 3-4 days ago he was spotted in the warm-up room here doing 260 kilos. Squat.
Yes, set up.
So two Colombians in the competition. Always interesting. They'll push each other. They're all hoping that their respective fans will help them to get the better of their respective opponents here.
So you can just see first lifter preparing to come out. He's taking his time.
This
is Anglo Riviera, Colombia. Just getting ready. Final preparations on. Lifting suit up, t-shirt off. You can see he's got some strapping on his shoulder. I don't imagine that's anything serious. Just for a bit of assistance, maybe psychological as well. The tape on his neck, it's probably because he's ripped it in training. Just to stop blood on the bar.
Well, sit back with Michaela Brees and myself, David Goldstrom, as we get underway. It's a really noisy arena. They're all up for this. It's very much a rock and roll atmosphere in here. They've been entertained regally and musically for the past 30 minutes, but now it's down to business. And it's the first of the two Colombians, Edison Angulo Rivera, third in the Pan American Championships this season. Hails from Cartagena, not too far from the Caribbean. Father of two, a boy and girl, who will be watching dad all the way back in Colombia. So fingers crossed he gets off to a good start here. 143 on the bar.
Having to stagger forwards because he dropped his chest at the bottom. That doesn't matter, it's a good lift, first attempt.
So 143 on his way. That's just a couple of kilos short of what he lifted in the Pan Ams. Good group of Polish fans over on the far side. You just started to see a group of them. This hall can take something like 4,000. It's huge. It was, as you could understand from its title, the Centennial Hall, opened 100 years ago when it was actually a weightlifting competition in this hall. And there is the man they've all got to beat, just beginning with a 20 kilo bar.
Yes, all of these lifters will start light, David, just with a bar to stretch out, loosen off before they start loading up.
And the Bulgarian now, Demir Demirov. Now, we've not seen this man for, well, 4 years and a bit, because he was one of the 12 Bulgarians who was banned for taking an illegal substance back in June 2008. Was allowed back into the sport in 2012, but this is his first competition since coming back from that ban. 145 kilos on the bar.
Very quick, confident opening attempt.
So we don't know a great deal about him, but we do know that he lifted 153 kilos on his way to the bronze medal in 2007.
Gabriel Mena, Colombia, please prepare. Przygotowuje się.
Dimitru Kapchari from Moldova, capital of which of course is Chisinau, where most of the lifters are based. Kapchari. And that's not an auspicious start, Michaela, because he didn't total in the Universiade this season. That was in July, when he was actually up at 85 kilos, and he's come back down to 77.
Well, that just looked at all impressive for a first attempt. It was nowhere near.
So the competition moving at quite a pace at the moment. And this is the second of the Colombians. Got a personal best of 145 kilos. Comes from the north of the country. A place called Turbo Antioquia.
wow. Power snatch. You're not supposed to be able to do that in an A group at the World Championships. Power snatch is defined by anything caught above 90 degree knee bend. That really was quite straightforward. The only problem with this is it really does limit how much you can lift. He's obviously got tremendous leg power and leg strength, but you're not going to be able to lift big weights with that kind of technique.
Father of two boys, you'll also be watching Dad. Well, that's how we understand it from his colleagues talking to them earlier. Now Kaptari to try and make amends.
Well, it was a better attempt. At least that one went to arm's length. Just rushing the start, he's going to be finding himself under a little bit of pressure as he goes out for his third and final attempt in a moment. Just cutting that very short, didn't get the full leg hip extension that's needed. You see, loading up 110 kilos on the bar in the back there for Christoph, Poland.
Yeah, Christoph Zawaric on a little bit of a prowl. Polish fans are in, as you can see. Comes from the Flota Club up in Gdynia, Gdansk. Seventh in the Olympic Games, the pole, but an incredible 47 kilos behind you, the Olympic champion. When you've become Olympic champion and won the Worlds on a couple of occasions, you have a certain presence in the warm-up room and on the stage.
Not just that, he's world record holder as well.
Yeah,
he really
absolutely
does have some serious credentials behind him. And still loosening off, no need to put any weight on yet. If he warms up already, it'll be too early.
Well aware of the camera there, wasn't he? This is going all the way to China live. Now, this is where this auditorium needs to get behind this man. We never like to see anybody going out of the competition, particularly as early as this, but very important. Now, come on. No. And I'm afraid that's two major championships in a row now, Michaela, where he's failed to total.
Well, very, very disappointing for any lifter to bomb out. But on the world stage, as you said, twice in a row, goodness me. He just looks like his head's not in it at the moment.
So, Edinson on now. Bar going to 146 kilos. And remember, this would only put him into third place because Alejandro González Baez from Spain in that B group competition earlier today lifted 147. So nobody's surpassed the B group number one as yet. It will happen though. 3 kilo increase.
Well, same problem as the first with those extra few kilos. It really exposed him. Watch the slow-mo replay as he comes off the floor, just watch his bum lift, pulls him forwards onto his toes.
Now, just looking at the opening weights here, just to give you a guide to where we're headed. Liu, the Chinese number one, not going to come into 170 kilos. Very early days, as you can see, in the competition. The Polish favourite, Christoph Zawaric, 158, is posted for his opener. And then you go to the People's Republic of Korea, Kim Kwang Song, 155 for him. Richard Takach, 150, so we're not that far away. But you can see on that graphic how many people have yet to get going. So this is one of these unwelcome moments where he's got to follow himself. He's got a minute in which to come out now and readdress the situation, try and get these extra 3 kilos. If he gets them, he'll have a personal best by 1 kilo.
Rivera, Colombia.
I was talking to the coach of Lady Solis, who was in the women's event earlier today. You remember she matched her entry total at 240, having come back after, you know, giving birth to their first child. And he was absolutely delighted. He said that was spot on.
Oh, she worked really hard for that, really well deserved.
Good group, the Colombians, I must say.
Yeah, they've got a good team, strong team. They're making most of the A groups as well.
Now, he's got 25 seconds. And good boy. What we want to see when somebody fails at the second attempt, puts it together, comes out and makes the third one. So he's got a kilo personal best.
Still drifted onto his toes as he came off the floor, but managed to correct it. Nice and strong, nice and straight underneath the bar. He's going to be chuffed with that.
It's going to be interesting to see what he does in the clean and jerk. He's done 182. He's posted a total of 345. Now, when he was the bronze medalist in the Pan Ams, he got 327. So he's got a bit of work to do. But now this is Richard Tkach representing Slovakia. And he reappears on a competition stage after 2 years out of the sport. He was found out in an out-of-competition test. Prior to that, though, he was the European bronze medalist in 2011 in Kazan with 152 kilos. Although, if you go back to Goyang in 2009 at the World Championships, 158 is what he achieved there. Well, it was almost down to the wire, 5 seconds left as he lifted the bar, but that's a score on the board now, and he goes into first place, 149, the B group now surpassed, and Slovakia with the edge.
It really is disappointing how many lifters are coming back from a doping suspension. But hey, onwards and upwards, let's hope they're, can only hope they're clean now. And
well, all you can say really is they've done their time for the crime. But also what you have to say is, whatever our personal feelings about it, Michaela, they are allied and tied into the rules of WADA, which is, you know, the universal judgment around the world as to what you're disqualified for and how long you're disqualified. And that's as we saw with the British Olympic Association, that a difficult rule to actually argue. But anyway, enough of that. Let's concentrate on the lifting. And this is Demir Demirov, and 150 kilos on the bar.
Nice and solid underneath the bar, wasn't he?
Lovely. What a very
confident lifting there. He's calling the shots, he's telling the coaches what he's doing.
So takes the lead. And sprightly onto the stage while you're looking at this. It's Gabriel Mena of Colombia. Really bounced up the stairs. Good sign, though. It shows you that he's got something about him. He wants 150 kilos here. 5 kilo increase. He got the first one. So now, this would be a 5 kilo personal best. He was a bronze medalist in the Pan Americans, but some 5 years ago. Coming to 10 seconds.
And as we said earlier, that power snatch really is going to limit how far he can go. need to catch up lower, much, much lower, to be able to get under those kind of weights now.
So he now faces the same task as his teammate. He's got to come back with the third attempt. So it's got a bit of weight on the bar here.
Looks like Lewis starting to warm up. So a bit of weight, 60 kilos, that's it. Yes. Looks like it's going to be his first warm-up weight.
Yes. And at the bar, staying at the moment at 150 kilos. Nobody else seems to want that weight. Zawaric of Poland on 158. New on that big 170 opener. Alimov of Uzbekistan, 153. Kim of North Korea, 155. Chedimai, Albania, waiting in the wings for 153. Tagian from Iran, 160 kilos. So, can he do this? It is for a personal best.
And he's well strong enough. My only guess that he's not sitting into a full squat because he's got problems with his knees. Oh, that was better. Best we've seen him lift.
Just makes so much difference, doesn't it? You know, now he can go and prepare for the second half with, you know, some real zest about him.
Absolutely, he was given that 2-1. I'm not sure what the one failure is for. I didn't see anything wrong with that. That looked fairly good to me.
Interestingly, in the women's competition, you remember we were talking about Marina Manova of Belarus, and there was that 2-1 decision. I was talking to Taisto in the interval about Taisto Kupala, who's the president of the jury, about the decision, and the jury had it 4 whites to 1 red, but they have to have a unanimous decision, and the guy on the 1 red wouldn't budge. Oh. And otherwise they would have turned it over and she would have got a good lift, but it changed her whole afternoon. Shkamankova, that's it. Marina Shkamankova.
Two good lifts to one lift that was nowhere near. That just exposed his technique there. Not so good technique, but he swings the bar quite a lot.
Yeah, did you feel him slightly rushed as well?
They had plenty of time, but that just pulled him onto his toes. Really wasn't in a good position to drive powerfully upwards.
And there is Rasul Tagian, 26 years of age, in the very famous city of Isfahan. They call it, or, well, more about that when we see him. They're quietly confident, the Iranians who are in the hall here, that he's in with a shout of a medal today. So Richard Takac, second attempt on 153. Now this again is a 5 kilo increase, which seems to be the popular uplift for the second attempt. Slovakia. Was actually an 85 kilo lifter in early days from 2006 to 2009, but since then has been pretty solid at this weight category.
Very good technically, not much wrong with that at all.
Well, Ludwig Kalinov się przygotowuje.
Yeah, they don't produce too many top lifters in Slovakia, but then you have to put that into context from their relatively small population. You wouldn't expect it, but here's a man who could well be a contender. This is 24-year-old Alimov, Ulugbek Alimov, representing Uzbekistan. Put in a total of 360 kilos, which is right up there with the best. Actually, the same total as the Olympic champion Liu. One of the lighter men of the class, weighed in at 76.31. That may come into play. And this year, runner-up in the Universiade in Kazan, fifth in the Asian Championships, although he was the Asian champion in 2012. And 155, straight away, this would be a personal best by a kilo. And just to reiterate, when I say personal best on a competition stage authorized by the International Weightlifting Federation, not what he may have done in the training hall.
Short through the middle.
Now he put it up from 153 to 155, which suggests that, you know, the warm-up has gone right, but if you're going to go for the big prize, that's not the way you start.
Really lacking that explosive leg power through the middle. Needed to generate more height on the bar. I'm sure the next one's going to be better. I'm very frustrated with that.
Real Law fans for North Korea here to see Kim Kwang-song take on this championship challenge. 155 for his opener. And I've got to say, that's conservative for him when he considers this season already in the Asian Championships he lifted 164. But the most important thing is that he's on his way.
Yeah, he's got to start somewhere. It's always good to get one in. Sets the nerves at bay.
Just worth reiterating that the North Koreans currently in second place in the medal table. 3 golds, 10 silvers. And some of those just might have been converted into golds. Frustrating set of results really for them at the moment. Now this is Çelimay, Erkan Çelimay from Albania, from Tirana. Gets the first lift, and also another lift who's coming back from suspension, in his case a year, which is usually as a result of taking a stimulant, nothing worse than that, but nonetheless it's on the list and he shouldn't take it.
I remember Erkan competing as a schoolboy lifter, really, nothing more than that, out in Austria, what was the Fulda International, now the Junior Battle. And he was a lifter then that really blew the competition away from a very young age. And it's good to see that he has progressed through all the ranks to be competing and contending on the world senior stage.
Now, Alimov. Under pressure. Must get this if he wants to play for the big medals later in the competition. Good correction.
Yeah, still far from perfect. He had to take that couple of steps forward to get back underneath it. A good lift.
To second spot. Bit of relief.
Much better extension, much better leg power.
Richard Tkach for Slovakia, looking
to make it 3 out of 3. He's gone to 156, so now, as you would expect, having taken a 5 kilo increase from first attempt to second attempt, now 156, a 3 kilo step that would put him into first place for a few moments at least. 156 is still all-time best.
Yeah, the top ones are in here.
Let his backside lift up as he came off the floor there. He's going to pull him on to his toes. Hard to correct it after that.
So that really halts his advance. So the whole getting welcome. Bear man. Krzysztof Zawaric of Poland, European fifth a couple of seasons ago, seventh in the Olympic Games in London, coming down from this year's European Championships in Albania from 85 kilos to 77. 158 kilos on the bar to go straight into first place. Cheer now, they almost cheered a little too early. But he's got it, three white lights.
That's a big pressure coming out of your home country, home support, making an absolute racket, lifting the roof off, he composed himself very well.
And the one thing he wouldn't be used to is this sort of noise for him. So from Isfahan, next man on the stage will be the Iranian. Rasul Tagian. Comes from the city of 1.5 million. It's a real crossroads. The main roads going north, south and east, west. They meet in Isfahan. And if you go back to the 16th century, well, Isfahan was the capital of Persia at that time. Arms almost at fully extended on the bar. Not the start we were expecting at all. This man won the Universiade Championship in Kazan this year and also the Asian Championships at his weight category. So,
the same weight, take it
up there. Anything, just rush that starting position. Heels are off the floor before he even lifted.
And there you see, well, Poland in the lead at the moment while there's a little repair work going on the bar. I think somebody just sort of just caught themselves. You always have to clean the bar, clean the blood off if there is any. So Chenimai in second place, Uzbek in third. There you are, one man still to come, Liu Shi and one of the organisers there, the young blonde lady there, Monica, who's been looking after an awful lot of the diplomatic and VIP guests that have been coming to the championships over the days. Rasul Tagian. Now, he was one of my four. He was one of my four to be a big player tonight, so again, now this is real pressure.
After that first attempt, David, he didn't impress me very much. not so much the fact that he missed the weight, but positionally, heels off the floor, everything's going to be on his toes, everything's going to be out in front. He needs to really take his time.
...30-second buzzer in the background.
I spotted that movement in the elbows, not sure the side referees would have done. Fraction movement in the on his right elbow, we'll see this hopefully on the replay. Lucky to get away with it. I'm not going to see it from that angle. You really do need a head-on.
You need a head-on, don't you? Yes,
his
absolutely.
His right elbow. Fraction of a movement. Goodness me, the referees are being so strict here. Good lift. 2-1.
It's not a question of being strict. It's a question of being accurate. Alimov. Uzbekistan. Third and final attempt on 158. So in a way, Michaela, he's made a bit of a recovery here because having got that score on the board, he lifted 154 in taking the silver medal in the Universiade and he totaled up 351. He's posted a total of 360, equal to the Chinese double world champion and Olympic champion. So he's, in a way, despite that one failure, kept himself on track.
Yes, I think you know, he's kept himself on track, but we've got to be careful not to look too much into the weights that they posted. I know it used to be a bit of fun and games. You'd quite often put your total in heavier than you could do just to see if you could psychologically affect any of your competitors. And Cheremai bounced out onto the stage just a second ago. It's a great way to fire the legs up, bouncing up those steps.
So 4 kilo increase, and again, this would put him into first place, and it is only his second attempt. Just finished his law degree just recently. Five seconds. He lost that. He lost his way completely on that.
Trying to tug that bar too early with the arms, not using his legs to maximum efficiency. Very frustrated. Through his shoulders, way back from the bar, never going to get under it from there.
Well, three of my four of the top entry totals now have slipped up once. This is Kim Kwang Song, and you can see the situation there. Tagian of Iran on 158, also Ulugbek, but they've lost a life each in getting to where they are now, which is actually enhancing the chances of Krzysztof Zawadzic of Poland.
Well, interestingly, Jeremiah has opted to increase the weight for his third attempt.
Well, he missed 159, he's going for 160. A kilo. As you've explained, Michaela, not really much of a difference. It's more in the head than physically an impediment. But nonetheless, he needs this because otherwise he's going to be left on 155 and could find himself too far back, even for the clean and jerk half of the competition. Now remember, he only moved the bar with 2 seconds remaining. He's got 35 seconds now.
Just a have a little glance towards the clock. There is a clock just in front of the side of the platform. That's when the lifter is on the platform, on the bar. Another little look there. He knows exactly how long he's got.
Coming to 15 seconds. Second failure. It wasn't the weight, it's just got into his head now, Michaela.
There's an awful amount of frustration there. He's obviously a weight he's well capable of.
You know that feeling when you try too hard and you tighten up and you lose all the, you know, the natural flow and rhythm. So out comes Kim Kwan Song, People's Republic of Korea, and there's a big cheer coming up at 161 here. So this isn't a 5 kilo increase, this is a 6 kilo increase. Second attempt. And he's in the money. Very much in the money in the first half of the competition.
That's one of the most impressive lifters we've seen. Consistent, fiery, in great shape.
Made progress. He was junior Asian champion 2 years ago when he totaled 330 in the space of a year. He's moved that up to 355. I'm not sure whether this will help him or...
As long as it goes quiet now,
yeah,
gives him a chance to focus. That's what he's just asked for.
Just inside 30 seconds here for Krzysztof Sawaric, Poland.
More impressive than his first. That really was a fantastic lifting. Under the pressure of the home crowd, he really nailed that. Firing all cylinders.
And that's a 6 kilo increase. And just to identify for you what that means in terms of positions, remember Sawaric weighed in at 76.64 and Kim of North Korea 76.32, so he's the lighter of the two. Now Tagian, bar's gone to 162. This is just a kilo short of his lifetime best. Needs to move. That is simply not good enough. One out of three, 158. Valuable kilos given away here.
And the reason you just heard a cheer from the crowd when he got that is that's a guaranteed medal for the Poles. Just got to confirm the colour now.
Yeah, in the lead is Kim of North Korea. Second place at the moment is Sawaric, is silver. Remember, Kim's got another career, another lift to take here, but so has Sawaric. At the moment, they're both looking for 163, but remember that if Kim gets this, then Sawaric will have to go up from 163 because he's heavier. So he'd have to go up to 164. Just wants to see what happens here first, but I think the odds are in favour of this young man getting it. from what we've seen, and the youngest of the class completes a really good set of three.
Anybody watching this wants to know what a good receiving position is on the snatch. That was it. Couldn't have gone any deeper, and he found that position first time. No messing. Absolutely brilliant.
So it is Kim who leads at the moment. 163 ahead of Savaric. Now the bar, as I explained, would have to go to 164, and that's where it has gone. And then it's all down to the double world champion, the Olympic champion, and the snatch world record holder, who will have three lifts and the entire stage to himself.
Now this lift to decide whether he ends up with a silver or a bronze.
And this 164 is 14 kilos up on what he lifted as an 85 kilo lifter in this year's Europeans. So he really has prepared for these world championships. Well, the damage isn't, I suppose you could say, awful, because he's at this particular moment in third place. Well, he will be in third place.
Just got a quick glimpse of his hand there. He has ripped it, taken a callus off. Yeah, that's going to hurt.
Haven't seen too much of that, actually. So, Liu Xiaoshun, he is the man, 29 years of age, snatch world record holder, 175 kilos, set last year at the Olympic Games, and of course he took the gold medal. Even the best have dodgy days, and in the National Games of China this year in September, he tried 170 and he missed both of those before he got it on the third attempt, so nothing is certain.
Oh, his first attempt is definitely certain. That was super quick in the groove.
Really, you know, we got really quiet as well, very calm on the stage, very quiet. So now what does he want to do? Well, what he wants to do is to give himself a cushion of advantage in terms of kilos. That 165, remember, that is already 2 kilos ahead of Kim of North Korea, and it's 4 kilos ahead of Zawadzic of Poland. So the bar surely is going to go to 170, and that's where it's headed, I believe.
You can see he's got quite a big lump there on his collarbone, on his left collarbone. Either looks a bit like a cyst almost, probably from where the bar's been resting on cleans and front squats. It's going to be fairly uncomfortable, I'd have thought, but nothing he can't deal with.
Yes, weightlifting's definitely one of those sports where you learn about mind over matter.
Oh yes, pain becomes irrelevant. You have to learn to love pain, becomes your friend. It's not a muscle in the body that you don't use. Your hands get ripped to pieces, your neck gets ripped to pieces, and the fatigue and the muscle soreness that comes with it. I've got to ask, why do we do this game?
So 5 kilo increase, and of course this is going to make it incredibly difficult for anybody to come back at him. When you look at the weight that he's posted for the clean and jerk, 205, Svadic 190, the Iranians posted 200, but of course he's in trouble having missed two of his attempts. So second attempt here, 170, 5 kilos short of the world record that he owns.
Well, he's nailed that. How much further can he go? He's going to need to find some more leg drive.
Well, if he wants to go for the world record, I see no problem about having one go at it, because now, you know, when you consider he's sitting on 170, so, you know, he's got 9 kilos up on Svaric, and he's, you know, 7 kilos up on Kim. He's not going to take 171, that's for sure.
You know, the one thing that really impresses me about every single Chinese lifter that we've seen here today, sorry, not just today, this week, and I'm sure we will continue to see, is how good physical condition they're in. Not just all over, they're not carrying an ounce of fat on them, and yet they are so mobile, so flexible. They don't neglect anything. They pay 100% attention to every single aspect.
Now, what does that say? Well, is he? Yes, 176. He's going to have a go at the world record. That's all. That's
176.
And I think it's the right thing to do if he's in the mood for it and he feels good to increase his own snatch world record by a kilo. And almost putting the championship to bed in the first half.
Successful there, so I think the rest of the competition.
They're fighting for silver and bronze here.
Saying that, you know, we have seen Chinese lifters bomb out, so
yeah,
you can't be too complacent, but he's going to be coming out all guns blazing for this one.
Well, he's got, if he does get this, of course, he's got a wonderful position, because he can adjust totally to what happens in the second half of the competition as people win or lose their lifts. Now, just because he's posted 205 doesn't mean to say that he's going to come out. Mind you, there is something in the back of my mind that he might try. And it's a record that stood for an awful long time, but more of that. Let's just focus on this moment. Now, 175 he's done. But is he physically, is he mentally harmonized to do this? He has half a minute to win it.
To break his own world senior record.
Oh yes, it is. It's there. What a fantastic set. And Liu Shaoxun of China is the man. He really is the man. Well, forget about those failures in the national games. But because look at his physique.
The coach is telling him off because you can get disciplined for taking your leotard off on the platform. But do you know what? That was a world record. Who cares?
Yeah, he's been watching too many football stars, hasn't he? But they only get a yellow card for it.
Could you imagine somebody saying, actually, you're not having that world record because you're taking your leotard off? Awesome lifting. So brilliant.
Yeah, really good. And what's he going to do in the second half? Goodness gracious me.
Well, one thing's for sure, he's going to make the most of this 15-minute recovery. He's going to go and chill out. He doesn't even need to start warming up until the clean and jerk is halfway through.
Yeah. What we were alluding to, both Michaela and myself, was the fact that the clean and jerk world record, Oleg Peravchenov set that in the European Championships in 2001 in trenching. And many have tried, none have succeeded, and that may be on the agenda, who knows. But there it is, you can see there, 176, that's 13 kilos of advantage over the North Korean. And then you can see over Christoph Zavaric there, he's got what, 176, that's 96, 15 kilos. And as we said, it's the silver and bronze for the rest of fighter, but a terrific performance, and the champion has not let us down. and the record holder, 165, 170, and now having 176 loaded onto the bar, just chalks up there and coming to the bar and looking for a snatch world record.
Taking his time, setting himself.
Oh, that is unbelievable. And he just makes it, Michaela, look so easy.
Oh, technically so efficient. Caught it in such a deep receiving position. He gave that absolutely everything. Really well deserved world record.
Yeah, and you can just see he really loves this. He loves the position that he's earned.
Bit of a showman at the end there, but you know what? He deserves it.
Absolutely. And you know, it's good for the sport. It's good for the spectators to see an athlete, you know, of this quality, of this class. So often in the year after the Olympic Games, it doesn't quite take off, but this is special.
Oh, special beyond belief, and I wonder how far he can go in the clean and jerk.
Well, it looks as if he's well on his way to a third world championship. Just about 7.5 minutes to go before the clean and jerk begins. A very good evening and welcome to a real rocking arena here in the Centennial Hall in Wrocław in Poland for the men's 77 kilo championship of the world, alongside myself, Debbie Goldstrom, as ever, Michaela Breeze with her expert eye on 11 of the best to be striving for this prestigious title. We're just about 7 minutes away now from the first lift, and as you'll see in a moment here, this hall really is now with an atmosphere that we've been missing for the early days. But one of the reasons for that is that Poland have got a live medal chance in the shape and form of Krzysztof Sawaric. And this, of course, the early scene here with the lifters in this excellent warm-up facility. And there is the man of the moment as far as the Polish fans are concerned. But this is a field which is packed with talent. We've got world champions, Asian champions, Pan-American champions, European medalists, Olympic champions. And the body weights, which were finalized in the last hour, range from 76.23 to 76.98, and here are the contenders. And there you can see Dumitru Kaptari of Moldova. He is the heaviest at 76.98, and Erkan Çerimay of Albania, the lightest man at 76.23. But now an opportunity to meet each of the contenders in person, beginning with this man representing Bulgaria, Demir Demirev, world bronze medalist back in 2007. This is the hope of Poland. This is Krzysztof Sawaric, seventh in the Olympic Games. Next, the Olympic champion and two-time world champion. And then 79. So just about 3 minutes to go, and before we get underway here, the B group, which contested the 77 competition earlier in the day, the best performances came in the snatch and also in the clean and jerk from this man, Alejandro González Baez, representing Spain. And this, after two successes, 142-146, this, Michaela, was his best snatch effort.
Yeah, really attacked right through the middle, didn't he? Working hard, up to 147, just 1 kilo ahead of his second attempt. Great lifting from González of Spain.
And then in the second half of the competition, 178, and then
coming up with the second attempt here at 183. And this ultimately was his best clean and jerk.
Taking his time, really just rocking in the set position there, building himself up. Exploding into the clean, working hard to stand out.
Couple of steps forward, but he makes it. And putting the 183 clean and jerk together with the 147 snatch, giving himself a total of 330 kilos, and that is the leading score at the moment. So that is the score that tonight's finalists have to overcome to make sure that he doesn't climb up the table. 330 in comparison to the totals that have been put in is good, but it's modest by the A group standard, which is what we're going to see today. There's the man of the moment, the world record holder, two times world champion, the Olympic champion. And just to whet your appetite, about 3-4 days ago he was spotted in the warm-up room here doing 260 kilos squat, paused. So two Colombians in the competition. Always interesting, they'll push each other. They're all the hoping that their respective fans will help them to get the better of their respective opponents here.
So you can just see first lifter preparing to come out. He's taking his time. Anglo Riviera, Colombia. Just getting ready. Final preparations on. Lifting suit up, t-shirt off. You can see he's got some strapping on his shoulder. I don't imagine that's anything serious. Just a bit of assistance, maybe psychological as well. The tape on his neck, it's probably because he's ripped it in training. Just to stop blood on the bar.
Well, sit back with Michaela Breeze and myself, David Goldstrom, as we get underway. It's a really noisy arena. They're all up for this. It's very much a rock and roll atmosphere in here. They've been entertained regally and musically for the past 30 minutes, but now it's down to business. And it's the first of the two Colombians, Edison Angulo Rivera, third in the Pan American Championships this season. Hails from Cartagena, not too far from the Caribbean. Father of two, a boy and girl, who will be watching Dad all the way back in Colombia. So, fingers crossed, he gets off to a good start here. 143 on the bar.
Having to stagger forwards because he dropped his chest at the bottom. That doesn't matter, it's a good lift, first attempt.
So 143 on his way. That's just a couple of kilos short of what he lifted in the Pan Ams. Good group of Polish fans over on the far side. You just started to see a group of them. This hall can take something like 4,000. It's huge. It was, as you could understand from its title, the Centennial Hall, opened 100 years ago when there was actually a weightlifting competition in this hall. And there is the man they've all got to beat, just beginning with a 20 kilo bar.
Yes, all of these lifters will start light, David, just with a bar to stretch out, loosen off before they start loading up.
And the Bulgarian now, Demir Demirov. Now, we've not seen this man for, well, 4 years and a bit, because he was one of the 12 Bulgarians who was banned for taking an illegal substance back in June 2008. Was allowed back into the sport in 2012, but this is his first competition since coming back from that ban. 145 kilos on the bar.
Very quick, confident opening attempt.
So we don't know a great deal about him, but we do know that he lifted 153 kilos on his way to the bronze medal in 2007.
Gabriel Mena, Colombia, please prepare. Przygotowuje się.
Dimitru Kaptari from Moldova, capital of which of course is Chisinau, where most of the lifters are based. Kaptari. And that's not an auspicious start, Michaela, because he didn't total in the Universiade. Coming into first place, and it is only his second attempt. Just finished his law degree just recently. Oof. He lost that. He lost his way completely on that.
Trying to tug that bar too early with the arms, not using his legs to maximum efficiency. Very frustrated. Through his shoulder, way back from the bar, never going to get under it from there.
Well, three of my four of the top entry totals now have slipped up once. This is Kim Kwang Song, and you can see the situation there. Tagian of Iran on 158, also Ulugbek, but they've lost a life each in getting to where they are now, which is actually enhancing the chances of Krzysztof Zawadzic of Poland.
Well, interestingly, Jeremiah's opted to increase the weight for his third attempt.
Well, he missed 159, he's going for 160. A kilo, as you've explained, Michaela, not really much of a difference. It's more in the head than physically an impediment. But nonetheless, he needs this, because otherwise he's going to be left on 155 and could find himself too far back, even for the clean and jerk half of the competition. Now remember, he only moved the bar with 2 seconds remaining. He's got 35 seconds now.
Just took a little glance towards the clock. There is a clock just in front of the side of the platform. That's when the lifter is on the platform, on the bar. Another little look there. He knows exactly how long he's got.
Coming to 15 seconds. Second failure. It wasn't the weight, it's just got into his head now, Michaela.
Well, there's an awful amount of frustration there. He's obviously a weight he's well capable of.
You know that feeling when you try too hard and you tighten up and you lose all the, you know, the natural flow and rhythm? So out comes Kim Kwang Song, People's Republic of Korea, and there's a big cheer coming up at 161 here. So this isn't a 5 kilo increase, this is a 6 kilo increase. Second attempt, and he's in the money, very much in the money in the first half of the competition.
One of the most impressive lifters we've seen in consistent, fiery, in great shape.
Made progress. He was junior Asian champion 2 years ago when he totaled 330 in the space of a year. He's moved that up to 355. I'm not sure whether this will help him or...
So long as it goes quiet now,
yeah,
gives him a chance to focus, that's what he's just asked for.
Just inside 30 seconds here for Krzysztof Sawaric, Poland. And that's a 6 kilo increase, and just to identify for you what that means in terms of positions, remember Sawaric weighed in at 76.64 and Kim of North Korea 76.32, so he's the lighter of the two. Now Tagian, bar's gone to 162. This is just a kilo short of his lifetime best. Needs to move. That is simply not good enough. One out of three, 158. Valuable kilos given away here.
And the reason you just heard a cheer from the crowd when he got that is that's a guaranteed medal for the Poles. Just got to confirm the colour now.
Yeah, in the lead is Kim of North Korea. Second place at the moment is Sawaric, is silver. Remember, Kim's got another career, another lift to take here, but so has Sawaric. At the moment, they're both looking for 163, but remember that if Kim gets this, then Sawaric will have to go up from 163 because he's heavier. So he'd have to go up to 164. Just wants to see what happens here first, but I think the odds are in favour of this young man getting it. From what we've seen. And the youngest of the class completes a really good set of three.
Anybody watching this wants to know what a good receiving position is on the snatch. That was it. Couldn't have gone any deeper, and he found that position first time. No messing. Absolutely brilliant.
So it is Kim who leads at the moment. 163 ahead of Sawaric. Now the bar, as I explained, will have to go to 164, and that's where it has gone. And then it's all down to the double world champion, the Olympic champion, and the snatch world record holder, who'll have three lifts and the entire stage to himself.
Now this lift to decide whether he ends up with a silver or a bronze.
And this 164 is 14 kilos up on what he lifted as an 85 kilo lifter in this year's Europeans. So he really has prepared for these world championships. Well, not the damage isn't, I suppose you could say, awful, because he's at this particular moment in third place. Well, he will be in third place.
Just got a quick... Nice and solid underneath the bar, wasn't he?
Lovely. What are you very
confident lifting there. He's calling the shots, he's telling the coaches what he's doing.
So, takes the lead. And sprightly onto the stage while you're looking at this. It's Gabriel Mena of Colombia. Really bounced up the stairs. Good sign though, it shows you that he's got something about him. He wants 150 kilos here. 5 kilo increase, he got the first one. So now, this would be a 5 kilo personal best. He was a bronze medalist in the Pan Americans, but some 5 years ago. Coming to 10 seconds.
And as we said earlier, that power snatch really is going to limit how far he can go. Need to catch up lower, much, much lower to be able to get under those kind of weights now.
So he now faces the same task as his teammate. He's got to come back with the third attempt. So see, there's got a bit of weight on the bar here.
Looks like Lewis starting to warm up. So a bit of weight, 60 kilos, that's it. Yes. Looks like it's going to be his first warm-up weight.
Yes. And at the bar, staying at the moment at 150 kilos. Nobody else seems to want that weight. Zvaric of Poland on 158. New on that big 170 opener. Alimov of Uzbekistan, 153. Kim of North Korea, 155. Chedimai, Albania, waiting in the wings for 153. Tagian from Iran, 160 kilos. So, can he do this? It is for a personal best.
And he's well strong enough. I only guess that he's not sitting into a full squat because he's got problems with his knees. Oh, that was better. It's the best we've seen him lift.
Just makes so much difference, doesn't it? You know, now he can go and prepare for the second half with, you know, some real zest about him.
Absolutely, he was given that 2-1. I'm not sure what the one failure is for. I didn't see anything wrong with that. That looked fairly good to me.
Interestingly, in the women's competition, you remember we were talking about Marina Shikamanova of Belarus, and there was that 2-1 decision. I was talking to Taisto in the interval about Taisto Kupala, who's the president of the jury, about the decision, and the jury had it 4 whites to 1 red, but they have to have a unanimous decision, and the guy on the one red wouldn't budge. Oh. And otherwise they would have turned it over and she would have got a good lift, but it changed her whole afternoon. Shkamankova, that's it. Marina Shkamankova.
Two good lifts to one lift that was nowhere near. That just exposes his technique there. Not so good technique, he swings the bar quite a lot.
Yeah, did you feel slightly rushed as well?
Kanceri Mai, Albania. First
they have plenty of time, but that just pulled him onto his toes. Really wasn't in a good position to drive powerfully upwards.
And there is Rasul Tagian, 26 years of age, from the very famous city of Isfahan. They call it, or, well, more about that when we see him. They're quite quietly confident, the Iranians who are in the hall here, that he's in with a shout of a medal today. So, Richard Takac, second attempt on 153. Now, this, again, is a 5 kilo increase, which seems to be the popular uplift for the second attempt. Slovakia. Was actually an 85 kilo lifter in early days from 2006 to 2009, but since then has been pretty solid at this weight category. Yeah, they don't produce too many top lifters, Slovakia, but then you have to put that into context from their relatively small population. You wouldn't expect it, but here's a man who could well be a contender. This is 24-year-old Alimov, or Ulugbek Alimov, representing Uzbekistan. Put in a total of 360 kilos, which is right up there with the best. Actually, the same total as the Olympic champion Liu. One of the lighter men of the class, weighed in at 76.31. That may come into play. And this year, runner-up in the Universiade in Kazan, fifth in the Asian Championships, although he was the Asian champion in 2012. And 155, straight away, this would be a personal best by a kilo. And just to reiterate, when I say personal best on a competition stage authorised by the International Weightlifting Federation, not what he may have done in the training hall.
Short through the middle.
Now, he put it up from 153 to 155, which suggests that, you know, the warm-up has gone right, but if you're going to go for the big prize, that's not the way you start.
Really lacking that explosive leg power through the middle. Needed to generate more height on the bar. I'm sure the next one's going to be better. I'm very frustrated with that.
Real Law fans for North Korea here to see Kim Kwang Song take on this championship challenge. 155 for his opener. And I've got to say, that's conservative for him when you consider this season already in the Asian Championships he lifted 164. But the most important thing is that he's on his way.
Yeah, he's got to start somewhere. It's always good to get one in. Sets the nerves at bay.
Just worth reiterating that the North Koreans currently in second place in the medal table. 3 golds, 10 silvers. And some of those season, that was in July, when he was actually up at 85 kilos, and he's come back down to 77.
Well, that just took a tall impressive for a first attempt. It was nowhere near.
So the competition moving at quite a pace at the moment. And this is the second of the Colombians. got a personal best of 145 kilos. Comes from the north of the country. A place called Turbo Antioquia.
Oh wow, that's a power snatch. You're not supposed to be able to do that in an A group at the World Championships. Power snatch is defined by anything caught above 90 degree knee bend. That really was quite straightforward. The only problem with this is it really does limit how much you can lift. He's obviously got tremendous leg power and leg strength, but you're not going to be able to lift big weights with that kind of technique.
Father of two boys, you'll also be watching Dad. Well, that's how we understand it from his colleagues talking to them earlier, and now Kaptari to try and make amends.
Well, it was a better attempt, at least that one went to arm's length. Just rushing the start, he's going to be finding himself under a little bit of pressure as he goes out for his third and final attempt in a moment. Just cutting that very short, didn't get the full leg hip extension that's needed. As you see, loading up 110 kilos on the bar in the back there for Christoph Poland.
Yeah, Christoph Zavaric on a little bit of a prowl, and Polish fans are in, as you can see. Comes from the Flota Club up in Gdynia, Gdansk. Seventh in the Olympic Games, the pole, but an incredible 47 kilos behind the Olympic champion. When you've become Olympic champion and won the Worlds on a couple of occasions, you have a certain presence in the warm-up room and on the stage.
Not just that, he's world record holder as well.
Yeah,
he really
absolutely
does have some serious credentials behind him. And still loosening off, no need to put any weight on yet. If he warms up already, it'll be too early.
Well aware of the camera there, wasn't he? This is going all the way to China live. Now, this is where this auditorium needs to get behind this man. We never like to see anybody going out of the competition, particularly as early as this, but very important. Now, come on. No. And I'm afraid that's two major championships in a row now, Michaela, where he's failed to total.
Well, very, very disappointing for any lifter to bomb out. But on the world stage, as you said, twice in a row, goodness me. He just looks like his head's not in it at the moment.
So, Edinson on now. Bar going to 146 kilos. And remember, this would only put him into third place because Alejandro González Baez from Spain in that B group competition earlier today lifted 147. So nobody's surpassed the B group number one as yet. It will happen though. 3 kilo increase.
Well, same problem as the first with those extra few kilos, it really exposed him. Watch the slow-mo replay as he comes off the floor, just watch his bum lift, pulls him forwards onto his toes.
Now, just looking at the opening weights here, just to give you a guide to where we're headed. Liu, the Chinese number one, not going to come into 170 kilos. Very early days, as you can see in the competition. The Polish favourite, Krzysztof Zawaric, 158, is posted for his opener. And then you go to the People's Republic of Korea, Kim Kwang-song, 155 for him. Richard Takach, 150, so we're not that far away. But you can see on that graphic how many people have yet to get going. So this is one of these unwelcome moments where he's got to follow himself. He's got a minute in which to come out now and readdress the situation, try and get these extra 3 kilos. If he gets them, he'll have a personal best by 1 kilo. I was talking to the coach of Lady Solis, who was in the women's event earlier today. You remember she matched her entry total at 2:40, having come back after, you know, giving birth to their first child. And he was absolutely delighted. You said that was spot on.
Oh, she worked really hard for that, really well deserved.
Good group, the Colombians, I must say.
Yeah, they've got a good team, strong team. They're making most of the A groups as well.
Now, he's got 25 seconds. And good boy. What we want to see when somebody fails at the second attempt, puts it together, comes out and makes the third one. So he's got a kilo personal best.
Still drifted onto his toes as he came off the floor and managed to correct it. Nice and strong, nice and straight underneath the bar. He's going to be chuffed with that.
It's going to be interesting to see what he does in the clean and jerk. He's done 182. He's posted a total of 345. Now, when he was the bronze medalist in the Pan Ams, he got 327. So he's got a bit of work to do. But now this is Richard Takach representing Slovakia. And he reappears on a competition stage after 2 years out of the sport. He was found out in an out-of-competition test. Prior to that, though, he was the European bronze medalist in 2011 in Kazan with 152 kilos. Although, if you go back to Goyang in 2009 at the World Championships, 158 is what he achieved there. Well, it was almost down to the wire, 5 seconds left as he lifted the bar, but that's the score on the board now, and he goes into first place, 149, the B group now surpassed, and Slovakia with the edge.
It really is disappointing how many lifters are coming back from a doping suspension. But hey, onwards and upwards, let's hope they're, can only hope they're clean now. And
well, all you can say really is they've done their time for the crime. But also what you have to say is, whatever our personal feelings about it, Michaela, they are allied and tied into the rules of WADA, which is, you know, the universal judgment around the world as to what you're disqualified for and how long you're disqualified. And that's as we saw with the British Olympic Association, a difficult rule to actually argue. But anyway, enough of that. Let's concentrate on the lifting. And this is Demir Demirov, and 150 kilos on the bar. Just might have been converted into gold. Frustrating set of results really for them at the moment. Now this is Çelimay, Erkan Çelimay from Albania, from Tirana. Gets the first lift. Erkan also another lift who's coming back from suspension, in his case a year, which is usually as a result of taking a stimulant, nothing worse than that, but nonetheless it's on the list and you shouldn't take it.
Well, I remember Erkan competing as a schoolboy lifter, really, nothing more than that, out in Austria, what was the Fulda International, now the Junior Battle. And he was a lifter then that really blew the competition away from a very young age. And it's good to see that he has progressed through all the ranks to be competing and contending on the world senior stage.
Now, Alimov. Under pressure. Must get this if he wants to play for the big medals later in the competition. Good correction.
Yeah, still far from perfect. He had to take that couple of steps forward to get back underneath it. That's a good lift,
Second spot. Bit of relief.
Much better extension, much better leg power.
Richard Tkach for Slovakia, looking to make it 3 out of 3. He's gone to 156, so now, as you would expect, having taken a 5 kilo increase from first attempt to second attempt, now 156, a 3 kilo step that would put him into first place for a few moments at least. 156 is still all-time best.
So good, let his backside lift up as he came off the floor there. Just going to pull him on to his toes. Hard to correct it after that.
So that really halts his advance. So the whole getting welcome. Bear man. It's Krzysztof Zawaric of Poland. European fifth a couple of seasons ago, seventh in the Olympic Games in London. Coming down from this year's European Championships in Albania from 85 kilos to 77. 158 kilos on the bar to go straight into first place. Steered a little too early, but he's got it. Three white lights.
It's a big pressure coming out of your home country, home support, making an absolute racket, lifting the roof off. He composed himself very well.
And the one thing he wouldn't be used to is this sort of noise for him. So from Isfahan, next man on the stage will be the Iranian Rasul Tagian. Comes from the city of 1.5 million. It's a real crossroads. The main roads going north, south and east, west, they meet in Isfahan. And if you go back to the 16th century, well, Isfahan was the capital of Persia at that time. Arms almost fully extended on the bar. Not the start we were expecting at all. This man won the Universiade Championship in Kazan this year and also the Asian Championships at his weight category. So,
the same weight, take it at that. Look at Panesh.
anything, just rush that starting position. Heels are off the floor before he even lifted.
And there you see, well, Poland in the lead at the moment while there's a little repair work going on the bar. I think somebody just sort of just caught themselves. You always have to clean the bar, clean the blood off if there is any. So Chenimai in second place, Uzbek in third. There you are, one man still to come, Liu Shi Chun, and one of the organisers there, the young blonde lady there, Monica, who's been looking after an awful lot of the diplomatic and VIP guests that have been coming to the championships over the days. Rasul Tagian. Now, he was one of my four. He was one of my four to be a big player tonight, so again, now this is real pressure.
After that first attempt, David, it didn't impress me very much. Not so much the fact that he missed the weight, but positionally, heels off the floor, everything's going to be on his toes, everything's going to be out in front. He needs to really take his time.
...30-second buzzer in the background.
I spotted that movement in the elbows. Not sure the side referees would have done. Fraction movement in the on his right elbow. We'll see this hopefully on the replay. Lucky to get away with it. Not going to see it from that angle. Really do need a head-on.
You need a head-on, don't you? Yes,
his
absolutely.
His right elbow. Fraction of a movement. Goodness me, the referees are being so strict here. Good lift, 2-1.
It's not a question of being strict, it's a question of being accurate. Alimov, Uzbekistan, third and final attempt on 158. So in a way, Michaela, he's made a bit of a recovery here because having got that score on the board, he lifted 154 in taking the silver medal in the Universiade, and he totaled up 351. He's posted a total of 360, equal to the Chinese double world champion and Olympic champion. So he's, in a way, despite that one failure, kept himself on track.
Yes, I think you know, he's kept himself on track, but we've got to be careful not to look too much into the weights that they posted. I know it used to be a bit of fun and games. You'd quite often put your total in heavier than you could do just to see if you could psychologically affect any of your competitors. And Jeremiah bounced out onto the stage just a second ago. It's a great way to fire the legs up, bouncing up those steps.
So 4 kilo increase, and again, this would put